Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. In this series, we'll see how to enable logging in Python. This will help you to save complete command execution history into a log file, and this will be helpful for auditing or maintaining execution history or device configuration states. So this is the script which I'm going to explain in detail, and in this video we'll see an overview of this script. Here you can see I'm using Python's default library logging, and for enabling logging you need to do 7 to 8 steps. I have written here. Those steps I'll be explaining in detail in the subsequent videos. So before we go into these details, I'll show one more script. This script I have explained in another video, the previous video, where we parsed show version output. I'll be adding that video URL in the description and notification. If you're interested to understand this script, you can have a look into that. And we'll be enabling logging in this script. And both are same. Here only difference is I added logging. So first we'll try executing the parsing logic script. Let me just try running. So it is trying to connect to the DevNet CSR device, and it executed the show version command into the device using Paramico and got output. And here I have written some regex logic for parsing, and here I applied all these logics and printing the output. So the model number, version number, serial number details, uptime, everything. And here I am handling certain exceptions as well. If I want to execute this into the lab CSR device, you can just change it in this way. Here you can see my lab CSR details are here. Now let me just try running it. So you can see my CSR device details. The same script with logging is here. Let us do a comparison of these two scripts. For comparing this in PyCharm, what we can do, select both scripts and press Ctrl D. It will give a comparison. Here whatever is in green mark, which is related to logging, this I added for our reference to understand the logging levels. It is just a commented field, and here I am just enabling the logging using import logging and then creating a logger and adding the file handler and stream handler. I'll explain all these handlers and other logging levels in detail in upcoming videos. And this is, again, you can see here the parsing logic is same here in both places. And here again I'm adding something related to logging, and in each stage I'm adding a log. For example, while initiating the script, then connecting to the device, then while fetching username, then all these stages, and then after parsing each output I'm logging that. So version match, so you can see here, then model number, serial number, host name, everything I'm logging. So I'll be explaining this in detail. So before we move into the script, let's see the logging levels. If you go to the official document of Python, you can see the logging level. So by default in logging module, the logging level is set to warning. Warning means warning and above. So if you set this to warning, then it will print the logs above warning, warning and above. That means warning, error and critical. If you set to debug, it will print everything. Here you can see I have set the logger level to debug. We'll see this in detail later. And here I'm storing this into two files for the reference. In most of the cases we'll be storing it into a single file, but here to show the different levels, this I'm storing the info into one file and debug and debug into another file. Then in addition to that, I'm storing it into a stream handler. Let's have a look into what is handlers in logging. So this is a document which explains handlers. So you can see stream handler. So stream handler will send logging output to sys.stdout. That means the terminal of Python. And file handler will store it into a file. And SMTP handler will send an email, and syslog handler will send this to a syslog server. We can see here syslog handler that will send to a syslog server. Now let's try running the logging script. You can see in the folder, logging demo folder, I don't have any log files. Let me just try running the script. So you can see here connected to csr1.test.lab and parse the output. You can see I have two log files now. One is debug and one is info as per the file name, and each one is having the level. The debug file is having the logging level debug and above, and info is having info and above. And you can see when we give debug, it will store all the logs, and that will have more logging data. Let's have a look into that. So you can see this output. It is initializing connection to the device. You can see the timestamp, and even as a debug output, it is storing even the output, the show version output, what we received from the device, and even it is adding the parsed output. Now let's have a look into the info file. Info file is having very minimal information. Here it is showing only the connection information connected to the device, then username, and once connection is successful, it is showing the command details and the parsed output. So let's have a look into the script now. And if you see in the script, so in each place I'm just adding a logger. You can see here logger.info is initializing the script, and that came here in info log and in the debug log, because in debug it'll add debug and above, then it'll add even the info. And after receiving output, here if you see in the script, the output what we received, I am storing it as a debug message. So executing the command, then the output message what we received. So once we receive output, we are logging it as received output, and the output data we are storing only in debug. That's why debug is having more data. Now if you want, you can try even in the CSR1. I'll be adding this script in the GitHub. So let me just try changing to the Cisco CSR. Yeah, DevNet device. Let me just try running again. And let's verify the output now. You can see now the connecting device has changed to the DevNet device, and in the debug also I will be able to see the complete details. So here I have added two handlers for file, that's why we are receiving it as two log files. And in addition to that, I have a stream handler. Let's have a look into the stream handler. Stream handler is having the minimum logging level of warning. So that means let us verify it in logging file. So it will log warning and above, warning, error and critical. So all these levels you can define, depends on your requirement. Here in the script, here I have added authentication failed as warning message, and the parsing error added it as error, and unable to connect, other exceptions I added it as critical. So let's have a look into the authentication failed scenario. So here I'll change this to the lab device itself, and I'll try to simulate an authentication failed scenario. I'll give admin 1 here. Let us try running it, and you can see now I'm getting authentication failed, and the log message and timestamp it is adding. The timestamp it is getting from the formatter. I'll explain this formatter in detail in subsequent video. Now let's see our third execution. You can see even here also it is adding it as warning. Now if you want to change this warning level to info, let us change this to info. Now what will happen? In the stream handler it won't print in terminal, and now it is showing here as warning. Now let us try running. Now it won't print in terminal, it will just give the generic message authentication failed, which I manually added in the script, but still it is not logging here in terminal because stream handler can handle only warning and above, but my message is now info. So let's have a look into this. So you can see now the logging level has changed to info, earlier it was warning. So in this way you can customize it based on your requirement. You can just define the level, the logging level of each message. So similar to that, all the outputs what we receive, I am just logging it here. That's why we are getting the complete parsed output here in the log. And even you can send this as an email, or you can send to syslog server. Those things we will see later. And to enable logging, you have to do this 7 to 8 steps. I'll be explaining these steps detail in the next video. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.